A student at Millard South High could face a felony charge. Police say he shocked the athletic director with a stun gun today. KATV News Watch 7's Adrian Whitsett is working this story, and he is live with the latest.
Brandy, originally the police said the 16-year-old student faced concealed weapon and felony assault charges, but now they say the assault could be amended to a misdemeanor. And while that student faces charges, others say it's bad for their school.
One Millard South student says he watched as a fight between four or five people escalated Wednesday.
He wanted to protect himself, so he brought the taser gun, and then he tries to tase someone, to tase the guy that was going to fight him, so he misses, and then the guy starts running.
Omaha police say a 17-year-old student punched a 16-year-old in the face. That boy ran after his attacker with a stun gun concealed in his jacket. Athletic director Nolan Byer stepped in, getting stunned in the neck. Other students heard varying stories.
I didn't see anything, but I heard that there was Mr. Byers and Dr. Case got tased and some kid brought a taser to school.
But Lieutenant Darcy Tierney says it was only Byer and he wasn't injured.
It's my understanding that the stun gun was something that you would buy for personal protection.
You must be 18 years old to purchase similar non-lethal stun guns in stores, but you can find them for less than $100 online. Police aren't sure where the student got his, but Lieutenant Tierney says it shouldn't have been at school.
He was actually charged with carrying a concealed weapon, so no, it wouldn't be allowed to be concealable.
And Millard South students say the incident sheds the wrong light on their school.
I just think it's putting a bad reputation to our school, and it's kind of scary.
The safety is good, but people still bring things in. It's really bad.
Millard school officials say bringing a stun gun to school is just like bringing a normal gun, and they will expel the student for at least a year. Reporting live, Adrian Whitsett, KETV News Watch 7.